Ah, der kehrt.
About how this can change and what you envision
right.
happening in the form of churches and community centers. And in fact, 7 years now, you would like to see a computer located no less than 5 miles away from every black African American.
Exactly. Exactly. It's important. One of the key things that people have been talking about in the digital divide is the issue of access. Mm-hmm. And you have to have access to it. So that being said, yes, just as we have libraries that we're making available in the communities, then we have to make technology accessible in the minority community.
And even so strongly you feel about this that you think it's probably the civil rights issue of the coming years.
Absolutely. I call it the civil rights issue of the next millennium. When you put it in proper perspective, it's not simply an issue of just computers and getting connected on the internet. It's more an issue of your opportunities in the future, and that's what it's all about. Can you survive in the next millennium? And that makes it a civil rights issue, a crucial issue.
Okay. Also in your book, you do mention that historically, blacks have a tendency to reject new technology, to embrace what we're comfortable with.
Right.
I think this is not just blacks, I think this is an entire Southern mentality.
I think so. When you look at the African American community and what technology has meant to them in the past, then many African Americans kind of shied away from it. Case in point, every time there was a new technological innovation, it meant displacement in many cases. So there was a labor source that we provided. Case in point, I always bring up sharecropping. Well, what did that do to when the technology of the cotton picker came out?
Displacement.
Displacement and computerization in the factories.
But you've got to keep up. Schools can only do so much.
Exactly.
Has price perhaps been a barrier somewhat?
I think price has been an issue, but it's been more of an issue of perceived value. And when we want to look at price, for example, let's look at tennis shoes. Okay, the price of tennis shoes is definitely not inexpensive, but it's an issue of value. And so we need to focus on perceived value of technology. And then the price issue becomes more of a secondary issue. We figure out how to pay for it rather than I'm not spending that amount of money for this box.
Okay. Part of your effort to knock down some of these barriers involves a project you have that will be gearing up soon in Africa. Can you briefly tell us about that?
Yes, basically what I'm doing is I'm working on a distance education platform in Ghana, in West Africa. And basically the African continent is poised and primed to take advantage of internet technology and ultimately to link with the rest of the world. That being said, I was asked to work on a project through Stanford University to do just that.
Yes, you just received the Reuters Award, very prestigious.
Right, Reuters, Digital Visions.
Does your mind ever slow down?
No, we can't afford to slow down in 2001.
That's probably why you're in the digital age.
Exactly.
Right? Where can we get the book, and are you doing a book signing?
As a matter of fact, the book is available on Amazon.com. You can also go to www.detrickdeburr.com, and we will be at Afrocentrics Bookstore this afternoon in the Pecanland Mall from 5 to 7 o'clock, and then we'll be there tomorrow also at 3 o'clock.
Okay. Do keep us posted on your project in Ghana.
I sure will.
How that's going and what kind of inroads you're making.
I sure will.
All right, the book is called Deal Us In, How Black America Can Play and Win in the Digital Economy. And our author, Detrick DeBurr, 1987 graduate?
Exactly.
High school?
87.
Okay, and Southern University in Baton Rouge. Nice to have you with us.
My pleasure.
All right, we'll be right back.